Jack, wait a minute. You could be a trainer. You could work at public relations. You could, I mean, you love kids. You could go to schools and talk to them.
I'll give it a break, Barney. And look, don't get all mushy with Chief Danford over what we did this morning, okay?
Well, you guys did it again. Congratulations. Three people. Now, that's a pretty good morning.
Well, don't thank me, Chief. It was Jack. He's like a Labrador retriever.
No. It was Barney. He's got no nerve endings.
By the way, Jack, I was checking your report today. You're certainly one of the department's heavier hitters, but you've been KO'd in action 3 times in the last 5 months.
So?
So I'd like Doc Mallory to have a look at you.
Sure. Make an appointment for next week.
I took care of that. He's waiting for you now.
Now?
Yeah. Let me know how it turns out.
Yeah, sure, Chief. I'll get cleaned up and go over right away.
Good. Barney, see you in a minute.
Sure. Doc Mallory's always good for the latest joke.
You mean Mallory gave you a clean bill of health with fat cop?
No problem. Just a touch of bronchitis. He gave me a few antibiotics, and I'm home free.
You're one of my best men, Jack, but I hardly believe you're home free. Wait a minute, Jack. I want Walsh to work with Barney, not you.
What did he say?
I want you outside, on the pumps.
Yeah, sure, Chief. That's fine.
Jack! I don't want you to any more smoke for a while.
You got it.
You directly disobeyed your superior.
Chief, it was dangerous up there. It was a job for a pro. I looked at Walsh, he seemed to hesitate. I was feeling good, so I went for it.
Save it, Jack. I call the shots around here. Walsh is ready, and I sent him in. Do you realize that you blacked out twice in one day? Now, tell me about the doctor again.
I told you everything about the doctor, except I forgot to give you the letter. It was in my car.
Why is this handwritten?
Oh, yeah, he apologizes for that. His secretary was sick.
Thorough examination of department personnel, Mr. Jack Thornton, indicates normal status. I have prescribed mild sleeping sedative to relieve the bronchial distresses. Well, seems according to the book. Oh, is this the dog everybody's been talking about?
Yeah.
What's that?
Oh, that's just a bill that was in my car. Yeah, he's quite the dog. Quite the animal. Will that be all, Chief?
No, I'm afraid that won't be all, Jack. I'm going to supersede the doctor regardless of what he said. You've got a bad case of bad judgment, which I'm going to chalk up to exhaustion. But you leave me no choice. I'm going to suspend you for a week. I'll put in the report that it's to recover from bronchitis. Now, I want you to go back to the doctor and check this thing out again. Starting now, you have 7 days off, Jack. And I don't want to see you until you're feeling better.
Yes, sir.
Well, Jack, just for insurance, I'll call Dr. Mallory myself and make your appointment.
Thanks, Chief. That's very thoughtful of you. Well, this is certainly a fine pickle we're in, isn't it? What are we going to do? Where am I going to start? I guess I better put myself in Dr. Mallory's hands. What am I talking to you for? Sometimes I think you're the problem, sometimes the solution.